Rigging is one of those topics we all think we can handle like a champ, until we end up breaking the character and crying at how terrible our rigging skills really are. You know the feeling. You build a character in Moho, set up two smartphones to automate the animation, and then you realize you can't actually use them together. Today's question comes from one of my subscribers, Mahyar, who submitted it through the form I always link in the description. You can fill it out too if you'd like to have the same conversation with me on Google Meet. It's totally free. So let's take a look at the video Mahyar uploaded through his form, and then I'll show you the solutions we discussed in our meeting.
Hello, Mr. Modelman. I have a character here with bone for lip syncing. I have mouse up and down, large and small, and open and close mouse. The problem is when I'm going to turn the head, I fix this light like this to turn with the head. Okay, as you can see, it's a head smartphone and it's going to turn. The points will rotate with the head. Okay, the main problem is when I make a less on the face, like when I going to move this bone and make it less, the teeth light not moving correctly with these points. I can fix this points with this character when it's going up and down. That's it.
How long have you been working with Moho?
It's about 3 or 4 years. Did you see my videos on YouTube, Boston's? I reimagine and make friends animation right now. Not completely great, but I just trying to do this.
Yes, I've watched some of your videos. And I'm
Thank
sure
you.
That,
it's my pleasure.
And I'm sure that the project that you were asking about is actually one of the projects that you use for creating videos for your channel. The question that you asked is one of your projects for your channel. And I'm so happy that you're so open with this and you're creating content on YouTube using Moho. All right, so do you have my screen?
Yes.
I made a simple example and we're gonna talk about your problem. In this simple example, I got a head with nose and mouth and two creepy teeth. And if I do the head rotation, everything works fine, especially if I'm not on the frame zero. As you can see, we can do the rotation of the head. And smile also works. We can smile using this smartphone. So we got like a smartphone for head rotation, another smartphone for the smile. No problem with that. But your problem is when two smartphones are against each other and they're not working together. So they work individually. This works, but if I rotate and smile both of them at the same time, that's when the problem comes. Is this your problem?
Yes.
Okay, so let's talk about the solution now. As you can see here, I got only one layer inside this bone layer. And here we got like a point here, and you can fix this manually, but you're not looking for a solution like this. Basically, you want to fix it using bones. So one solution is that we can fix it manually, but it's going to take some time and it's not the best solution. How can we fix it using bones? So one solution is that you can actually create another bone as a smartphone, obviously, and call it like something like a smile fix. What are we going to do here in this smartphone? Let me show you. Before we apply the rotation or everything, we go to this smartphone, Smile Fix, for this bone. And as you can see, if I rotate this bone, let me go to a frame other than zero, like 72, to create the smartphone and rotate the bone. So here, other than rotating this bone, you need to rotate the other two inside the smartphone. You see the blue color here. We are inside the Smile Fix smartphone. We're creating the smartphone here. We rotate the other two and the smartphone itself. We rotate them all together. Yeah. Then you go to your layers and you fix the issue. You move the points, adjust them however you want, and fix it. When you fix the problem, you hit the B key, select, for example, this bone, hold down the shift key, add this bone to your selection so that you can select both of them. And then...
That's 72.
Yeah. And you remove this key here to delete the rotation. Now, if I rotate my bone, this one and the other one, we got this fix thing here. And you can, I'm working on this side, but look at this side. As you can see, if I rotate it, it'll fix it, as you can see. And even for like half rotation, which was your original problem. So let's say we're going to rotate it this much, not right to the left. As you can see, You can fix it using this bone. So you got a helper bone and you create it. And anytime you want to adjust the points and everything, you just rotate this bone. This is one solution to your problem. I have also another solution that I'm going to show you. Let me review it. So as you can see, the solution is simple. In a smart bone, you rotate the helper bone itself. Then you rotate the head rotation bone and smile bone. Rotate all three. Then you apply the fix by moving the points manually. You go to the layer and move points one by one to fix the problem. Then remove keyframes of head rotation and a smile bone, but keep the fixer bone or helper bone itself as it is. So as you can see here, we only rotated this one and we removed the keyframes for these two.
My first issue was when I rotate, for this example, when I was rotating the head, the teeth one is changing. Okay, you do this with the smart bone on head rotating, yes? Changing the
head
teeth with head rotating.
Changing the teeth with head rotating, yes. You see, I rotate the head and I can fix it using this smart
bone. Yes, with head rotation and the teeth is okay. When you're rotating the head, also the teeth shape is changing. And also when it's going to smile, do you change the teeth again with the smile or you
See. See, as you can see here, smile works. Smile works. See. Smile works.
Yes.
And I'm in the middle of rotation, not start end. In the middle of it.
Smile works, but the teeth didn't.
You can fix it using this one. That's why we created
with this one.
Yes.
Yes.
So it's just a helper bone. When it comes to fixing anything, you just rotate it. That's it.
Yes.
It's as simple as that. There is another solution that gives you more flexibility, because with this one, we don't have any flexibility. We can't really move the points too much. We got like this fixer bone or helper bone. We can just play with it to fix the rotation and everything. And as you can see, smile works. Even if in this example, as you can see, it doesn't work, but now we can use a smile fix to fix it. We just reduce the amount and now it works, as you can see. So using it, you can fix any type of issue, even with like smile, no smile, head rotation, no head rotation. It always works. Now let's go to the other solution that I was gonna show you. Let me delete these keyframes. And I duplicated this layer, the entire bone layer. I just copied it on top of it. As you can see, again, we have the same thing, but now we got like pin bones, some pin bones here. Are you familiar with pin bones? Do you know what pin bones is?
Let me show you.
So when we are on the frame zero and we want to draw a bone, if I hit the A key to select the add bone tool to draw a bone, as you can see, if I draw a bone, if I hit the T key, you can see that it has a length. But how can we create a bone without any length? You just hit the A key and click. That's it. We call it pin bone. That's what we call a pin bone.
I don't know how to use the
use
pin
it.
Bone.
Yeah. Okay, okay. Yes. You know what
What's
it is? You don't know how to use it. Okay, let's go into how to use a pin bone. So in this example, I just put some pin bones here by clicking and clicking and clicking. But the issue is that you need to first know where are the points, because we can't see points of this layer. We can't see the points of our layer when we select bone layer. To see them, you right click on your layer, go to quick settings and check paths, then you click on apply. When you do that and you go to your bone layer, you can see the points. It's kind of orange now instead of blue, but you can see the points and everything. But let's say you got like 100 layers, or let's say 10 layers, and it's hard to right click on all of them and go to their quick settings one by one. One of the ways is that you can hold down the control, select all of your layers, right click on one of them and go to quick settings and check paths. And when you click on apply, it's going to apply it to all of them. Another way, a simpler way, if I click on apply, this is the fastest way, is that you just go to display here. If you got like Moho 12, in Moho 12, you just click on display quality. We have fill and a stroke, you see?
Yes.
We have the same thing in Moho 14. Here, as you can see, if I go to display and uncheck fills and strokes, you can see all the points. You see?
Yes.
We can see all the points.
Yes.
So our teeth has like a point here, a point here, a point here, a point here. So we can see all the points. We just hit the A key and add the bones. So the next question that you ask, was, do they have a parent or something? And I'm going to talk about this now. No, they don't have any parent. As soon as you draw all of them, you hit the B key to select the select bone tool. You drag to select all of them. You hit the S key to select the bone strength tool. You type 0 so that they don't have any strength. Mm-hmm. Next, you're going to hit P to select the reparent bone tool, and you click on somewhere so that they don't have any parent. And then I'm gonna hit the B key again and click on somewhere to deselect these bones. You know how to connect one single point to a pin bone, or you don't?
Yes, of course.
So
yes.
This has a very fast rule that I'm gonna show you. I call it BI bind point. See, I hit B, select the bone, I select the point, bind point. Again, B, select, I, select bind point. You see, BI bind point, BI bind point. Yes. You do this again and again to rig all of these. Now that we did this.
So you make a bone on the points of the shape.
Exactly. Some people do that to have more control when it comes to rigging.
It's very good.
Yeah, but it's time consuming. You're going to spend a lot of time to do this because it's slower than the previous solution. My first solution was faster, but you don't have any flexibility. But with this one, you can do anything, but it's going to take some time. So let me talk about this one now. As you can see here, if I go to a frame other than zero and rotate this one and then rotate this one, now to fix this, you're gonna just simply move this. As you can see, you look here. Yes. You see,
wow.
I'm changing it. And if in case you want to like move one single point, or in case you want them to move with the teeth, you have to go back to your, for example, head rotation here. And instead of moving the points themselves, for example, instead of moving this point, I'm gonna delete its keyframes. So instead of moving it, I'm gonna move the bone itself. So I'm gonna hit the T key and move it right here. So, let me move this to one frame to the left. Okay, if I go back to main line now, as you can see, it moves with it. And now we have the same bone on the shape.
The rotating moves with a smile.
Exactly, and you have control over it. It's a bone and you have control over it. As you can see here, you can move the point. See?
But what about without a smile? We want to control without a smile and with a smile.
See, this is without a smiling. You still have control over them. You know, for example, for this one, if I move it upper, you can see the changes, yes?
Yes.
You have control over
it.
Without a smile. With a smile, yes, again, you can control them. There is no issue with it.
You do this with smart bone or with the timeline?
I just rigged it. I created a pin bone and rigged it. That's it. I connected the point to it. That's it. Nothing else. No smart bone, nothing. I just put a pin bone right there and attach the point to the pin bone. That's it. Then you can move it wherever you want. Even with head rotation.
It doesn't need any smart bone or handling.
That's why they are not against each other anymore. These two are not against each other. You can rotate them. And if you're not happy with the result, you just move the pin bones.
You can do anything with them.
Yes, exactly. Okay. This is a very fast solution. But just let me go through it and talk about the second solution for a second. Mm-hmm. So in the second solution, you either disable fill and stroke in display settings, as I showed you, or another way is to right click on your layer, go to quick settings and enable path so that you can see the path or points when you select your bone layer. Next, you create pin bones for the shape. And finally, you bind the points to the pin bones. This is the second solution, and this is the first solution.
Thank you very much.
That's it. That's pretty much it, my friend. Thank you so much for being here and having the conversation. And I know you because the first time that I put the link on my channel, you were one of the first persons that filled the form. I still have your previous form that you filled, but we didn't have the chance to have this conversation like right now. But you were very respectful. I hope you found the solutions very helpful. I will share this video soon. Have a nice day.
Thank you very much.